Celebrating Valentine's Day.
Yes.
You're having a great day. We are out of Arizona treating ourselves to lunch.
Yes. Yeah. They have a great menu. They have their Valentine's Day special. And then they have their traditional menu. But a lot of the items on there is really nice. I've never been to this before, so it's my
You are going to enjoy it.
Yeah. I can't wait to eat.
And get our drinks.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Last one.
Yes. I got me a Texas margarita.
Oh, you had it?
Yes. It's so good, so good. So,
what's in it?
What makes it a Texas is a shot of Grand Marnier on top of the regular.
Ooh. Ooh, I love Grand Marnier. It's really sweet.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Changes it up a little bit in the taste.
Yeah.
And they make awesome Texas. We're just continuing on with our day, loving on ourselves.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. It's nothing like self-love, self-care. Yes,
definitely self-love and self-care. Yes. If you don't love yourself, how are you going to love somebody else?
How are you supposed somebody to love you if you don't love yourself?
Exactly. So we out here treating ourselves to a wonderful lunch.
Mm-hmm. Excited.
And just chilling. So we'll tune back in once our drinks come.
Yes.
Girl DC and
JY.
Last day two. Celebrating Valentine's Day.
Yes.
You're having a great day. We are out of Arizona treating ourselves to lunch.
Yes. They have a great menu. They have their Valentine's Day special. And then they have their traditional menu. But a lot of the items on there is really nice. I've never been to this before, so it's my
You are going to enjoy it.
Yeah. Can't wait to eat.
And get our drinks.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Last one.
Yes. I got me a Texas margarita.
Oh. You had it?
Yes. It's so good. So good. So,
what's in it?
What makes it a Texas is a shot of Grand Marnier on top of the regular.
Ooh. Ooh, I love Grand Marnier. It's really sweet.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Changes it up a little bit in the taste.
Yeah.
And they make awesome Texas. We're just continuing on with our day, loving on ourselves.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. It's nothing like self-love, self-care.
Yes, definitely self-love and mm-hmm. self-care.
Yes.
If you don't love yourself, how are you going to love somebody else?
How are you supposed somebody to love you if you don't love yourself?
Exactly. So we out here treating ourselves to a wonderful lunch.
Mm-hmm. Excited.
And just chilling. So we'll tune back in once our drinks come.
Yes, yes.
We're back. Got our drinks, my Texas margarita.
Yes, and I have Moscato. Literally all I drink.
I love Moscato.
I love Moscato. I know it's like a dessert wine, but I literally drink it with everything.
I do too.
Everything. I love anything sweet.
You know what? That is my secret in cooking my mustard.
Really?
Yes. I use dry wine. Mm-hmm.
Moscato.
I just done told the secret.
Right.
I don't know. But I got some other things that y'all don't know.
But
I'll let everybody know. Moscato
is yeah, that looks good. I can't, you know. You know why? Yeah, this looks good.
Good.
Yeah. Sometimes I get the Moscato that's not really sweet. It's like, it gives you that sweet,
but it's not,
it's
yeah.
not sweet, sweet. Like, I can't explain it very
I know
well.
Exactly what you
yeah,
mean.
Yeah, I really like Fort Norris Moscato. Love it, love it. It's really good.
I've had that before. Good.
It's really sweet. I had it for the first time, probably, I was in college. And one of my friends, she was a really big wine drinker when we were in college, and yeah. Got me hooked onto that, and ever since then, I have not tasted anything that was that sweet as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I prefer a sweet wine, but I do like Merlot.
Mm.
I do like Merlot. But Moscato, that's my white wine.
Yeah, exactly. That's my go-to white wine. The only time I go for dry, if I want to be a little drunk.
She want to get there.
Because the dry wine will get you there. I don't know what it is, but it gets you there. Probably because I try to drink it faster because I don't really like their taste. But it definitely gets me there.
I don't like that bitter wine.
Yeah, I don't mind it sometimes. But I'll buy this. I'll only buy this. I'll drink dry wine if someone gives it to me. Yeah.
Well, I hope everybody's having a great Saturday.
Yes, I hope everyone's having a great Saturday as well. It's nice. It's nice here.
Beautiful here in Atlanta.
Yes, it is.
The sun is out. No rain.
No rain. It's been raining for days.
Like cats and dogs.
Flooding everywhere. It's been really gloomy.
My roof's leaking.
Yes, it's been really gloomy. So it's a lot going on here in Atlanta when it comes to the rain. It's nice today.
It's a beautiful day. The sun is out, and I thought I was gonna have to put on my bigger coat, but my jacket wasn't just cold.
Yeah, I'm always cold, so that's why I have this one. It's like 55 degrees, and I have like this little scarf on, but I'm always cold. So I have a sweater, my scarf, and I'm warm, so I don't have to have a coat on or anything. So.
You're perfect.
Yeah.
Because that just keeps the heat in right around there.
And I'm just nice and warm and toasty, so I'm not worried about that.
I keep a heater at my desk.
I wish I could.
I'm not supposed to. Ooh, should I say that on camera too?
Yes, I wish I could. I'm always running around at work, so I'm always like layered up. I always have like 3 or 4 layers going at work, and they always make fun of me, but.
Be warm. And then you get hot, you can just take off the layer.
Exactly.
And get cold, put it back on.
Yeah.
So us cold people have to know how to regulate.
Yeah. It's not fair to make other people extremely hot.
We'll burn them up.
I used to do it all the time. I didn't care. But like now I compromise. I just add my layers so everybody else can be comfortable.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Because I'd rather be hot than cold. Everybody else will say they'd rather
be hot. No. I'd rather be hot than cold. I'd rather be hot than cold because I can cool off.
Yeah.
Quicker.
Just take it off. I mean, listen. That's why they have new beaches.
Yes. I like hot weather.
Beaches, yes.
Well, they have new beaches in Cancun.
They should. It should have new beats in Cancun. Come on.
We'll see.
It should. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Okay. I've never been to a new beach.
I want to go. Me neither. There's one in Miami that I was supposed to go to. It's in North Miami. It's not on like South Beach or whatever. And I was thinking about going. A friend of mine used to live there. She said it's usually a lot of older men in Speedos.
Oh. Okay.
In Speedos. But hey, Speedos are new, so... Pick your poison. That we want to go for.
I want to see some buffalo.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm pretty sure they're out there too. Showing off.
Yeah.
Buffalo likes to show off.
That would be a nice trip.
Mm-hmm.
We need to make that happen.
I know. I got to figure out which beach is that. Because I know, like I said, I know it's in North Miami. I don't think it's in South Beach.
Find out when and we'll make a trip.
Yes.
We'll take y'all with us.
I love Miami. People always talk about Miami, but it's a nice little getaway. You don't have to spend like a vacation there. It's a getaway.
Yeah.
Quick one.
I've been to Miami twice. Once for the Super Bowl. No, I didn't get that. Once.
Okay.
Yeah, but only
once. I've been there a lot of times. Because I had a good friend of mine, she lived there, we were roommates in college, and she lived there for years, and when I turned 23, that year I was going to Florida at least twice a year.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I was going a lot.
Yeah.
It was so fun, like, and that was maybe a minimum. Sometimes I might go 2 or 3 times a year, because I like Miami, it's nice, it's a beach.
The weather's
amazing. If it rained, it was like for 30 minutes, and then the sun was back out. And
that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
And I moved to Atlanta for that.
That, me too.
From Connecticut. And I'm coming, I'm getting this Connecticut weather all the time now. What?
That's how I feel. It feels like Maryland weather because it'll be hot 1 minute, then cold the next minute, and it'll be raining, and then it'll be sunshine, or it'll be sunshine and rain.
Getting me sick.
Yes, I feel like I'm gonna get some vitamin C in me today because I feel like the weather is really jacking me up, man.
And now it's so beautiful. The sun is shining outside. I mean, it's like night and day from yesterday.
Yeah.
The past 2 days.
I mean, it was literally the grass was frozen last night when I was walking the dog. Today, it was. It was like frozen, and she licks the grass when it's frozen. So the weather difference is really crazy. It just really does. You get all four seasons in a week.
Yes, in a week.
In a week. So.
And when I first moved here, it was not like that. In 1990,
I was here in 2006 to visit my grandfather, who lives in Monroe, and it was January. It was 67 degrees. And this was consistently throughout the week. It wasn't like any type of really bad weather. And then in the summers, it was, of course, it's Georgia, so it was extremely hot. So to see it now, it really does go through all four seasons. It was snowing here the other day.
Yeah.
Like big flakes. I mean, huge ones. They were
I mean, big flakes.
Big old flakes. It was really pretty, but it's just like still something that you notice, especially
global
for someone who's lived here since the 90s, you see how it's changed.
It has changed. I've seen global warming in Atlanta.
Yeah. Yeah. Because in certain places where you get all those seasons, you might see the snowstorms might get worse, but that happens sometimes when you live somewhere where it snows a lot. But like you got places that are getting like tornadoes. I was like,
Crazy.
So, weather's just been crazy, but we're enjoying the nice weather today.
We are enjoying the nice weather, loving on ourselves.
Yes, weather for the lovers.
Yes, until we find our lovers.
Yes,
they're out there.
Yeah,
someone's
out there.
I'm waiting for him to come and snatch me up.
You know,
gracefully, though.
Me being a millennial, people like to slide in DMs. I don't like that too much.
Oh, yeah. No,
I like personal. Yes. I love meeting people.
Me too.
It doesn't feel like
it has to be
a stranger. Like when I meet you online or you try to like go out on a date from like offline or inbox or DM, it feels like stranger danger. It really does. Because it's like, But when I see somebody at a bar, at the grocery store, at work, it doesn't feel so like impersonal.
Yeah.
It's so weird when people slide in your DMs sometimes. But you have success stories when people got married and found the love of their life. But
I personally would like to meet someone out just random.
Yes, me too.
And just let it happen naturally, you know, when you least expect it.
Yes.
Because I'm not looking. I want it just to happen. If it doesn't happen, then it doesn't happen. Because I'm happy. I still travel. Mm-hmm. I still do everything that I want to do. And when I meet that someone, I want to continue on doing what I do and want him to be a part of it. And he knows that this is me. And you got to accept me for me.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to travel. I travel at least 3 to 4 times a year. So if I get with somebody, you can't be telling me, oh, money, you can't go, or you can't go. Because if you say you can't go,
that's on
believe
you.
Me, I'm still going. I don't need nobody telling me that I can't go because they can't go. No. So I really need a truly understanding brother.
Yeah, absolutely. Someone who knows that you're traveling is an extension of yourself, and this is a part of your identity.
Exactly.
So you're gonna take
it
or leave it.
I'm not doing nothing. I ain't cheating. I'm going to Mexico by myself Friday. I'm going to have a good time. I am going to film from there. I'm gonna try to go live, but I'm not going over there to do anything crazy. I'm going over there to get some sun, get a tan, eat some good food.
Enjoying
the moment. Enjoy your life.
Yeah.
Because I have some days I need to use up from work before they take them away from me. So instead of sitting at home.
Use it or lose it. I understand. Gotta go to Mexico.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Make it enjoyable.
Yeah.
Life is too short. You got to get out and enjoy life.
Yes.
You know, I tell all young people, I'm not telling you my age, but I'm telling all anyone, get out and do what you want to do. Don't put nothing off. I mean, life is too short. I mean, I had 4 clients that passed away in the month of January. Life is too short. So you got to get out and do. You don't have to spend a whole lot of money to do stuff.
No, absolutely not. You don't. There's so many, especially not here in Atlanta.
Definitely.
There's so many festivals that are free. Then you got a lot of college campuses in the city, so they have events for the students, but they open it to the general
to the public. Exactly.
So they, and you know, it's a historical town, you know, city, place to be. So there's so much that you can learn about your own history, or just the history of the U.S. period, being in the South. Because me being from Maryland, there's a lot of things that I didn't know until I got here. You sometimes gotta really submerge yourself into a city. And into your life, so you can enjoy it. So there's always something to do for free in every city, honestly. Every city. Eventbrite is a very great place to look for free events, Facebook events. So enjoy your life. If you can't travel, maybe.
Yes, and you don't even have to like go out of the country. Go to a different city for the weekend. You know?
New Orleans is close to here. You can drive there. Florida is close to here.
You can drive there, exactly.
If you're in New York, you can definitely go to Niagara Falls. There's, I know people who haven't even been to the Statue of Liberty who live in New York. So sometimes you just need to venture out to
your own city. Exactly. Martin Luther King Center. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. Venture out in your own city because then you're going to start.
And then the, what is the scooters
that they got the two wheels and you got the lift.
Yes, they, you can rent different tours. I did that. And it was so much fun. And it was like an hour and a half tour. And we went around the city of Atlanta, went to St. Martin Luther King Center.
Amazing.
And, I mean, just a lot of historic places. And learning how to ride that bike. They give you a 30-minute training.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. In the beginning, we got there like at 8:30 in the morning, and they trained us for like an hour or so. And then we went through the city for like an hour and a half and just rode around to the different historic places. That was so much fun. And they have different tours that you can go on. So that's a good thing. I had a Groupon for that.
Yeah, Groupon.
Don't sleep on Groupon.
Do not sleep on Groupon. We were speaking of self-care. They have tons of like massage places that you can get on there. The tours. We have this huge,
The wheel. The Ferris wheel.
They have this huge Ferris wheel. It's really up to code. It's really up to code. It's a really good Ferris wheel. It's really well known in Atlanta, actually, because it's right near Centennial Park. So they have that on Groupon. They have like the horseback riding and stuff.
Carriage ride.
It's really nice. So it's so many things you can do to really go out and travel. Even when they call it staycation.
You learn a lot about yourself
and it'll help with relationships. You gotta know yourself before you go into these relationships. People are lost, they don't know themselves.
Exactly. And then you want somebody to love you and you don't know yourself and they ask me what Wow, look at my Granny Smith apple salad, guys.
Oh yeah, that salad looks really good.
Oh, I said I might want to I think I might eat all of this and have to order another one.
Really, I have your traditional Caesar.
Yeah, it looks so good.
Yeah, it really does.
All right, let's say our grace. Lord, thank you for this food we're about to receive from mind, body, and soul. Amen. Oh my God. Okay, you know what? This salad is going to just get eaten up.
Yeah.
No, I don't. Oh my God. I'm glad they did this because I think I only need one. This is one of their best salads here.
We have the cheese parmesan.
Yes.
I love
I can eat, when I buy blue cheese crumbles, I eat them out of container.
Yeah, you know. Listen, I like them with club crackers.
Yeah.
Really good with club crackers. I really got into cheese, like really cheeses, when I was like a photographer for like a mobile photo booth.
Really?
And I would do these high-end events for like professional baseball players and politician kids' graduations, like DC politicians. So they would have these huge houses and nice events. And of course, me being a photographer, they were feeding me.
Okay.
And I had some amazing food just being a part of these events, because you get to experience stuff that you may have never experienced.
And you know what? That's something new. I never knew that you were a photographer.
Yes. Yes, I'm venturing back into photography. I'm getting a camera soon.
Okay.
Because I want my own photo booth, because I did it for somebody else. And it's a real lucrative type of business, because there's always an event that wants a photo booth.
Yes.
And a photographer as well.
Wow.
But the photo booths are so much fun. You got your props. You got different personalities. Sometimes you bring like shy people who are... Bring them out their shell. So, mobile photo booth showed me so much. I loved it. I was at birthday parties, weddings, graduations. I went to a Microsoft event in DC.
What?
Huge conference where they brought every single like big player in Microsoft from all over the world to DC to this convention.
Wow.
So I met people from all over the world. Like it was an amazing job. I really appreciate that job. It's a mobile photo booth. It's called Pixelated.
Okay.
In Baltimore. It was founded in Baltimore and it grew. It's now like all over the country. But yeah, it's
and amazing. I heard of them.
I love them. I love them.
I heard they got an app.
They may have an app now, but when I was working for them, they didn't. But
okay.
They had.
That sounds like so familiar.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they had a. They've been in so many events. And their hashtag, you know, when you post to your social media, people see it and they can like learn more about it and stuff like that. Yeah, I loved it. It's a really great job.
Mm.
It allowed you to be yourself. It was great. I loved it.
And that's one thing. One thing I love, being yourself, people letting you be yourself and you not having to be in a box.
Mm-hmm.
That's not me.
Conforming to what they consider on the
run. Exactly. Oh, your salad is so good.
This sounds good too. It's not like it's a really creamy dressing. What?
Yeah, I like their
but
food that is light and good.
It's like a creamy that's not really heavy. So it's really good.
I love this salad dressing. They need a bottle of this.
Is that vinaigrette?
Mm-mm. I don't even know. It's so good. It may be a raspberry.
Mm.
It's not like vinaigrette. There's no vinegar in it.
It's really good.
Yeah.
It's really, really good.
I see people coming here getting containers, so they need to just go ahead and bottle it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
it's really good.
Yeah. Good. You can get this and put chicken. Sometimes
mm-hmm.
I'll get this salad with a salmon on the side or a crab cake that I can't have.
You can't have seafood right now, guys. Gotta get my cholesterol down. Now with seafood, it's like loaded with cholesterol.
Mm-hmm.
It's somewhat good because it's the cholesterol your body can't digest, so it pushes some of the cholesterol out of your body. But when you eat a lot of it, because the body can't digest it, it becomes a problem.
Yeah, and I've been eating a lot of it, as y'all see. So, my doctor called me on a Saturday. He's like, you know, Miss Quinn, you need to break it down for your sister.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, you eat a lot of fried foods? I'm like, not really. Mm-hmm. He's like, I don't need air fryer. I've been using that for the past, like, 30 days. I eat a lot of seafood. He's like, that's it, shellfish.
Mm-hmm.
And I love shellfish.
How are you doing, ladies?
Good. Thank you.
Wonderful.
Yes,
thank
really
you.
Good. Appreciate it. Yeah, shellfish is literally like the life when, you know,
and
I love blue crab, Maryland blue crab. I love shrimp.
My cousin, I don't know if you saw my video, she taught me how to eat a Maryland blue crab when I was in Baltimore.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, you gotta get the females. And she's like, you gotta suck the yellow stuff. No, I usually just clean it out.
I don't clean it, but I'll just eat it. Mm-hmm. I'll, you know, I'm just a messy eater when it comes to blue crab.
It was really good. It was a good experience.
Mm-hmm.
And I love it. And I love butter. Linda Lake's butter is my favorite butter.
Mm-hmm.
I just need to walk around with a t-shirt and say, I love Linda Lake. Because that's another secret to my butter, is Linda Lake's butter. Because I've tried other butters, I've tried the creamy butters, but the taste with the Linda Lake butter and the Moscato. And my other secret ingredients, y'all only getting two.
Me too.
Oh my God. And like you said about the lemonade, when you change up that recipe, you can taste the difference.
You taste the difference.
Yes.
You always taste the difference. Sometimes cutting costs is not good.
No.
Not going to make it better.
No. Not.
You're going to change the taste and you're going to notice it. You're going to be self-conscious about it.
Yeah. Because when I make my mussels, everyone raves about it. They're like, you need a bottle of sauce. You know, they taking the bread, you know, after they eat the rest of the mussels, they sopping up the juice with the French bread.
Yes, I love it. Any juice that's really good.
Mm-hmm.
I love bread. Love bread. Bread has always been a problem.
That's the problem for me, too.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm so glad that she did not bring the bread.
Mm-hmm.
Normally they serve us a thing of bread, and I think she caught on that we were trying to be healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So she didn't bring us the warm loaf of bread.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. Yeah, the bread is cool. I'm kind of like wanting to go off and get some bread.
You actually
move. Okay. When it's hot, put that butter on it and milk on there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. Oh. Let me ask her. At least we can see it because we are entitled to it. No bread? Oh. There is no bread. So that's why we didn't get any. So God knew that we didn't need that bread. God knew we didn't need that bread. Mm. That bread is a guide for it. It's a little mini loaf. I just spread. We already have it when we break it off to 6 pieces and it's warm and hot. Put that butter on there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. This salad is so good. I just walked in.
like coming to large parties.
Really? Why?
Because the one when I actually went with was an actual large party, and it was already kind of paid for in advance. Everything's fine. And someone always has an issue with a check.
Okay.
The one where we're all just come together and it's not like kind of planned.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. Read it.
I can see that.
And I also read it because people personalities, when they're eating, when they're in a setting where there's food, and they're being served by somebody, it's completely different from how they interact with you personally.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it brings out a character you do not like or want to be around sometimes. I had a friend where we did not like eating out with her because she always made us see when we would go somewhere. Like, it was crazy.
Oh, yeah,
crazy.
People like that. It's
she
like they're making the attention on them.
Always really crazy.
The whole night. Something is always wrong.
Mm-hmm.
About their food or their drink or this.
Yeah. It was always something wrong. This girl asked, you know, carded us. We're going to look young forever. That's just the side effect of having melanin.
Embrace
you know?
It. Embrace it.
Embrace it. She pulled out the ID and didn't have the right kind of ID where they can actually serve you. She didn't have it. It was vertical, not horizontal. She never got it changed after she turned 21. I think we were like 23 by then. And I'm like, get your new ID.
Oh, God. Then you want to blame everybody else for the fault.
Because it's not expired, so it shouldn't matter. Well, she can't serve in vertical. It has to be horizontal. So if you don't have a horizontal ID, you're not getting a drink.
Wow.
The moment I turned 21, I was like, I'm getting my new ID.
So wait a minute. In Baltimore, they do it horizontal?
So what happened is you have your vertical for when you're underage.
Oh, okay.
And horizontal when it's legit, you're over 21. So she still had her vertical ID because our IDs take about, we were like 5 or 6 years to expire. Mm-hmm. So before she turned 21, she had just got a new ID. So she didn't want to get a new one because she didn't want to pay for it.
Oh.
So she was getting into places because they looked at the year and saw that she was 21.
Mm-hmm.
But restaurants and casinos will not allow you to come in with that type of ID because they just want to avoid any type of confusion.
Exactly.
So she got upset with the girl. I mean, made a whole scene. And I was like, I'm so sorry. We were at a bar, so our checks were already separate. And I was like, I'm sorry. I apologize for all that.
Oh, my God.
We laughed. It was just like too much. It was too much.
Yeah, that is too much.
I dread large parties.
And it's your fault.
Yeah, and it's your fault. I dread large parties. I don't know people eating. Your eating personality may just
be. Oh my God. Not perfect.
Yes. Etiquette.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I tore the salad up.
Yeah, the salad is really good. Really good. So crazy.
Oh my God.
So do you have any plans for this evening?
Well, I'm going bowling tonight. That should be fun.
Yeah.
Because I can't bowl. But I'm going to have a good time.
I always mess up my wrist. So technically I can't bowl either. I don't know how to do it accurately, but I know I do something. I can get some pins knocked out.
Yeah, I can get some elbow.
And two hands.
Exactly. Between your legs, that's me. All the way, and I ain't even judging.
Well, it's alright.
But I have fun.
Mm-hmm. That's not all that matters, honestly.
Yep.
It's about having fun now.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how to do everything. I'm gonna have fun doing it.
Exactly. I'm gonna stay young, mm-hmm. having fun. Mm. I feel like a good t-shirt.
Stay young, having fun.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, that's the truth, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's the truth. Just like they say, grandparents who are children a lot.
Yeah, stay younger.
Stay young longer. They live longer. So stay young.
Oh my god, this was so freaking good.
I've already finished mine. Yeah, the dressing is really good. Not exactly sure what it is, but it's
good. Yeah,
I wish we still had the menu. And I think it had it.
Yeah.
It's really refreshing.
It is.
It's a refreshing type of dressing. It's not like...
Wow, this is so good. Last bite.
It compliments your fruit dressing,
though.
The salad.
That was delicious. Can't wait for the main course.
Yes.
Whew. All right, we'll be back when the main course comes. Hey everybody, we got our main dishes.
Our dish looks amazing.
Those are Denver lambs, asparagus, and steamed spinach. Trying to stay on my keto.
Yeah, and I'm not on keto, clearly. I think it's a canyon burger. It has mushrooms, bacon, and the sauce that they have on it. They have garlic mashed potatoes. I love carbs. I'm not supposed to eat pork, but
that looks so good.
Or mushrooms, but hey.
Hey, you don't get it in. Oh my god.
You can cheat here and there. Not in relationships, guys. This is still lovers weekend.
Still lovers weekend, not relationships.
So how do you feel about monogamy? Is it like, are you big on it, or are you into the trend that people do like the whole polygamous?
Oh no, it ain't no polygamous shit. No polygamous. Thank you. No polygamous.
Yeah.
I need my own.
And that's,
I got you, boo. I can do everything and everything.
Somebody had said that, you know, monogamy wasn't natural, that you're supposed to have more than one spouse, and this is mostly for men. Women tend to want to be monogamous, it's like naturally comes, but men, it's not really natural. So I always say this to people, I don't care. You know, it's somebody out there who's on the same page as me. You don't have to be, and I'm not trying to change you. It's just, come to me either when you're ready to do that, or don't come to me.
I agree. I'm not into polygamy thing.
Not at all. Nothing against anybody who is. More power to you. But
no.
Just not into it.
No. Maybe in my early 20s, I might have been stupid and dumb for that shit. But now, not now.
I was really crazy when I was younger. I've toned it down a lot. So I was very possessive. So I probably wouldn't even been okay with it then, because I was just crazy. I'm glad I grew up.
Well, we all have to grow up.
Yeah,
you know, we all have to find ourselves. And in that journey, we know that monogamy is not for us.
Mm-hmm.
No. I mean, your dick needs to be mine. I'm sorry.
Mine's to me. I'm sorry. If you thought otherwise.
Keep it moving. Keep it moving. I'm not possessive. I'm not saying that you can have your boy's trip and do all that, because I want my significant other to be able to be himself, to go and have a boy's trip. Because I'm going to have a girl's trip. I'm like, you know that now.
Live your life.
Because sometimes I'm going to be around your ass. And that's just normal.
You need your space. You need your space. Everybody needs their space. Their me time.
Because if you can't love yourself, how are you going to love someone else? And loving yourself is having time for yourself and getting to know yourself. And you need that time and space to do that.
And not
understand
using
that.
Yourself.
Exactly.
It's a relationship. It's just for a man.
Exactly.
You cannot use yourself. Just
and that's where a lot of women, they get thinking they're going out there. Oh, is he going to buy himself? No, girl.
No. If you don't trust your significant other, there is no relationship.
Exactly.
You're going to always question everything they do. They can literally show you that they are being faithful. And they'll create something in their head.
Yeah.
We don't trust them. So you need to trust your partner.
Definitely.
You know, honestly, it's key communicating and also being able to comprehend what that person is asking.
Number one, comprehending.
Comprehending, because I can communicate all day.
Right, and you gotta comprehend that shit. And if you don't know, ask questions. Don't hold stuff in.
Yeah. There's no stupid questions. And I always say that, and sometimes I regret it, but there's no stupid question. Because if you truly don't know the answer,
you gotta get the answer.
You gotta get it.
It might be stupid for you, but it's
stupid. Yeah, exactly. You gotta get it.
For the outcome to come out right, I need to know the answer to determine my situation and value the situation.
Forward answer. Be honest.
Be honest.
The truth is not always pretty.
Exactly. We might not agree, but you have to agree to disagree, and you know my point, and I understand your point, why you don't understand my point, and move on. And that's life.
Yes, absolutely.
Because why I want to be with somebody that's totally like me? I want to learn something different. I want to see a different view. I might not agree with it.
You might not even truly want to be with somebody that's identical to
exactly.
You.
Exactly. That's boring. To know every move and every step? No.
Yeah.
I don't want to know his every move or every step.
Like spontaneous type of relationship.
Yes.
Someone a little different from me, because we'll both be able to bring something different to the table. That looks really good.
Real.
It looks really good.
Oh. Want to try one?
Sure.
Try one.
I got it medium well. I'm a medium girl.
Oh my god. They got me right there.
This one?
Mm-hmm. It is so freaking good. Denver lamb ribs.
When I was younger, I would not eat lambs because I used to watch this show called Lamb Chop on PBS.
You thought it was the lamb?
I thought it was lamb chop. So I would not eat lamb. But I love lamb man. Sorry, lamb chop.
Lamb chop, you good today. Ooh. Oh my god. So good.
Really good. Really tender.
I'm right off the bone.
Mm-hmm. Really good.
No rice, the music playing in the background.
It's a little
buffalo flavor. Okay. Oh my god. It's
really good.
Happy Valentine's Day, DC. Mm-hmm. Thank you, DC. You're welcome, guys. Yes. Last night was so fun and funny. I can't believe I broke my ring camera. I'm glad my phone didn't break.
Yeah.
So this slams right down on the floor.
One thing about the iPhone, very sensitive.
Oh, speaking of that, I need to buy a portable battery.
Oh, yeah, the one that you can charge.
Yeah. I want to be able to film and not run out, you know, being out in the on an excursion.
Oh yeah, while you're in Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Well, of course you know, if you go to any like home store, Walmart, Amazon.
Yeah, that's my point. Amazon
has everything.
Well, I have to order my new ring light, so I'll order that at the same time. I went to go order it last night, and I was looking at the video trying to download it, fell asleep. I woke up with the phone on my chest. TV playing, lights on. What did I do? I went downstairs and got the rest of my lemonade.
Lemonade's really good.
It was good. This still is good. This is good.
Burger is really good too. Another burger that's cooked perfectly. It's not like dry.
Juicy.
It's juicy. It's like the sauce that comes on top of it isn't like not heavy. Just kind of like the dressing. Mm-hmm. It goes really well with it. It doesn't dominate the taste of the burger. So you still taste the burger.
Good. I've never had a burger here. But all my friends and family are telling me they've had the burgers.
Mm-hmm.
I'm waiting to buy the burger.
Mm-hmm. You can tell I'm an American. Always eat burgers.
This is so good.
The bread's good. Yeah, meat fell right off the bone. It's really good. Really tender. The sauce that they have on it is really good on there.
I got honey glazed.
Rose honey glazed?
Mm-hmm.
It makes you want to like lick the bone.
I know. Stuck it.
Mm-hmm. The honey glaze would go well with the burger.
Yeah, that would be real good.
Real good.
McDonald's burger.
Yeah, no. 8 ounces.
Mm-hmm.
Well, so. And they ask you how you want it done.
Exactly.
You want it rare, medium.
No, you're not looking for billionaires. But millionaires would be fine.
Yeah.
100,000 there, you'd be good too.
Mm-hmm.
No, but just somebody with a loving, warm heart.
Yeah.
That loves me for me. That can see me for me.
Mm-hmm.
And I can see them for him.
Exactly.
And we can grow together.
Absolutely.
I bring something to the table, you bring something to the table. And I'm not looking for no sugar daddy or nothing like that. I'm looking for a true brother.
I've always been sociosexual. I love a man that I have.
Me too.
They teach me something, you know. Someone that's intelligent.
Yes, I love a guy that I can learn something from.
It's nothing like
that. That feeling is just like so like, wow.
You just literally, I'm literally in awe of you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just like.
Yes.
I'm literally in awe of you.
Teach me something every day.
Yes.
I'm a big thing, even at work, I'm like, mm-hmm. learn something new every day. So in life, you learn something new every day.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my challenge to you guys. Learn something new every day.
every day.
Anything. It doesn't matter what it is. Just burn something new every day. Yesterday I learned that my ring light can't sit on the couch.
Yes.
Small, but I learned that.
Mm-hmm.
Learning something new every day.
Every day.
You always love yourself. God first, then yourself. If you got a husband and your children and everything else after that. That's my order.
Yeah. I'm big on not losing your identity.
Yeah.
Just because you take on other
person's name.
Yeah, take on another person's name. Or you pick up other characters in life, you know. All of us are having multiple personalities. So I don't want anybody to think they don't, because when you're at work you're with someone.
Exactly.
You know, when you're at home, when you're with your significant other, when you're with your friends.
We all have.
And it's not fake and phony, it's just certain people bring out certain emotions, certain characteristics
out of you. Exactly. Yeah.
So
that is so true.
Yeah, it's, you know, so it's just like we gotta remember that you can't lose your identity just because you become a mom or because you become a wife. Or you become a manager or CEO of a company.
Mm-hmm.
So really understand that how you are with different people is still an extension of yourself.
Exactly.
Who you are.
Don't forget yourself. Because I'm not like this at work. So that's two personalities. I'm another way when I'm with my mom. And another way when I'm with my dad.
Yes, absolutely.
And another way when I'm with my sister. Another way when I'm with my nephews.
Mm-hmm.
Another way when I'm with my girlfriend. I got a lot of personalities.
Yeah. And that's perfectly fine. Mm-hmm. And it's very appropriate.
But it's all a part of me. It's all wrapped up in one.
It's very appropriate. There's levels of respect that you have for each person and how you conduct yourself and who you are with them. And then there's the respect that you have for yourself because you're who you are alone. You know, you are who you are alone. And being alone, you find out a lot about yourself. What you think about when you're alone, weird stuff.
Yes, believe me, I know.
Like,
and it's good.
Think about that? Yeah, because you're kind of ciphering through your head, trying to figure out your different thoughts.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, being alone is not bad. Being lonely is a different thing.
Right. Right.
Lonely means you don't want to be, but you don't have a choice. Alone means this is the choice that I'm making. And it's a positive choice. Most
times. Well said. I am not lonely.
Mm-mm.
I'm just alone.
I'm just alone. And I'm perfectly fine with it.
Perfectly fine.
Yeah. I'm like DC said, I'm not looking. There's no reason to look. It comes.
It's gonna happen.
That's it. It comes. You literally can find the love of your life pumping your gas.
Yes.
Like
grocery shopping.
Grocery shopping. Running into CVS to get
you. Running to the Nike store.
To get your stuff. Your lady stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yep.
Just random points in your life.
That's the best.
Yeah. Honestly, don't want it to be so cliche. I want it to be random.
Very random. You know?
Very random. And that was really good. Really good.
This was my last.
This was Arizona's.
Georgia.
I'm saving mine because I eat once a day, so it's going to be considered once.
Mm-hmm.
And plus, I got a little tiny stuff.
I'm a little bit bigger. I'm devouring mine. But I actually do think I'm going to save my vegetables.
Veggies?
Like,
yeah, they were good. The spinach was good. I'm not really
spinach
asparagus.
Was off the chain.
I didn't like spinach when I was younger.
Yeah.
I hated it.
I'll be like, ew, don't give me that.
Didn't like it. Then I started eating like spinach salads. and I still wouldn't eat it cooked because like, I really didn't like it cooked. But then I had it sauteed one time. My stepdad, because he's a really great cook, he's one of the reasons why my mom got big. She lost the weight.
Daddy, you feed her.
Exactly. He used A1 sauce.
Ooh.
Yeah, like butter and A1 sauce and sauteed the spinach. Amazing.
I'm about to try that.
It's really good. Yeah, he does his onions like that too.
No, I can taste the onions.
It's amazing. It's really, really good. So I loved it. And ever since then, I've been eating. I love spinach dip now. All types of anything spinach I'll eat. And when I went on my diet, that was one of the main things I would eat because I couldn't eat anything else. But I love spinach now. That and broccoli.
Love broccoli, cauliflower.
For years I did not eat cauliflower or zucchini. I love zucchini.
I love it, and I can eat it raw.
Yeah, me too.
Love
going on these diets. Sometimes it opens up your refrigerator, honestly. Your refrigerator and things that you didn't have in there before, you start putting in there. I love it.
Yeah, and cauliflower. Mm-hmm. I just really like in the past year start eating cauliflower and
maybe 3 years
like roasted in the oven. Ooh, it brings out the sweetness in the cauliflower. Oh, yeah.
They had like this cauliflower chicken. It was supposed to be like your version of chicken, but it's cauliflower.
Okay.
Cauliflower.
Like a vegetarian.
Yeah, it's a vegetarian dish. So that was really something I was interested in tasting. It tastes good, but it didn't taste like chicken.
Okay.
It was somewhat.
Does it also have like cauliflower rice or something?
No, I think so, yeah.
But I don't know. I don't do a lot of
vegan and vegetarian dishes.
Well, no, I do. Out of not just knowing that I'm eating vegan, I just do that.
Mm-hmm.
So, buying frozen meals, like Sara Lee and Rewatchers, I don't do those.
Yeah, no, I don't do those either.
I don't like prepackaged meals. I'll do the like frozen vegetables.
Yes.
Like, that I'll do, but just like the prepared meals, I just.
They're never seasoned well, and because they were cooked already and frozen, when you warm them up, it has like the consistency isn't really good. The only thing I think when I was younger, I loved the cuisine kits.
Well, you know what? I'm gonna tell you one thing.
The brownie
was
amazing.
The
brownie, it's the only thing I can eat.
The only thing that I do, I take that back, give it back. The macaroni and cheese, Stouffer's.
I haven't had it.
That's the only processed food that I can eat. Well, frozen food. Because I've done the
I do Popeyes.
The noodles.
I haven't had those. I do the T.F. Chang's beef and broccoli in the bag. It's really, really good. If you get it on jasmine rice, you add soy sauce in it when you're cooking it. Maybe a little butter. It's really, really good. I love it. We have Chinese beef and broccoli. And then I do Popeyes. Sarah Lee's. No, not Sarah Lee. Marie Callender's. Her Popeyes, her chicken Popeyes, the extra large ones. They're great. Don't send them out. Take them immediately out of the freezer. Put it in the oven at like 400 for like an hour. You can't be like hungry.
Okay.
You gotta be preparing it for like dinner, literally.
You gotta prepare to get hungry.
And you put in there for an hour, really good. So that's the only frozen foods that I can say that like processed food that I'll eat. Everything else is just really bland to me. And they have to do it like that because sometimes, like you said, it might be Weight Watchers.
Yeah.
But with spices, you can usually use a lot of spices when you're on diets. It's usually like salt and like sugar.
You can't do that.
But some of these prepackaged stuff need to learn how to use spices.
Yes, they make it very bland.
Very bland. But you know what? Everybody's palate isn't good. Everybody's palate isn't good. Of course, we bought treats.
I bought desserts, y'all. Happy Valentine's Day.
Oh, mine's all smushed up.
Oh, get another one that's not smushed. Eat him. Happy Valentine's Day.
Yes. What up? Amen. Right on, right? That's the way you're supposed to do it.
Oops.
Valentine's Day.
Yeah, we didn't get none of this.
Yeah, no.
So I guess that's the downside of Valentine's Day.
Yeah, it's the only downside.
That was the only downside. We didn't get none of this.
We got presents, which was snacks and stuff.
But we ate these.
Yeah, yeah. We had something to eat.
We did have something to eat.
Perfect ending to a Valentine's Day.
That was so good, J-Wise.
Yes, exactly.
Well, guys, we're not going to keep you so long. But thank you for having lunch with us today.
Absolutely. Thank you.
So fun. Enjoy, y'all. Peace out.
Your Saturday. It's still quite early.
Yes, it's very early, so I'm going to go take a nap for my bowling. Mm-hmm. Peace out. Love you guys. Mwah. EC in the house and
J-Wise.